Hey guys, my name is Fabe and welcome back to another episode in the Dinosaur Mine. I'm still wearing our fancy helmet. I don't know how much durability it actually is. Hey, oh, I see you down there. Are you interested in me, good sir? I better be careful. One thing I didn't really notice, you see it on top of the screen? And I think on the bottom? No, only on the top it looks like. There's like this little shadow, which is kind of the same like when you're wearing a pumpkin. You only can see through the eye holes. It's kind of the same... the same thing where you have an overlay when you're wearing this helmet, which, I don't know, I don't mind it. It's just barely noticeable when you look in the sky, when you are indoors or so. You barely notice it at all. So I'm gonna keep that. If it's getting too annoyed, I can get rid of it. I think it's a setting in a config file. But yeah, that's also something they changed with the update. But you know what? Before we do anything today... both are still here! Manfred and... our unnamed second mammoth. This creeper there is really worrying me. Can I get out of here? Like, ninja style? I don't think I can. I would have to jump 1.5 blocks, which I cannot. I don't even know why I tried it. I knew I couldn't make it. But yeah, guys, today I think I want to spend some time at the East Dock. And I'm gonna try and get some progress done. You guys know that I don't have too much time at my hands at the moment, but I really wanna build here. So I think I'm gonna start with the warehouses. As I was mentioning, going for like an industrial style. I haven't chosen the blocks yet, but I'm thinking a little bit of these rusty factory blocks I wanna have in there. And I mean, one possibility could be bricks. Because, like, there were kind of at harbors and ports, there are sometimes these giant old brick warehouses. You know what I mean? I hope you know what I mean. I'm not sure if that would work well, though. Because we don't have anything in this style over here. But it could look nice. So I'm gonna experiment around a little bit. And maybe I'm gonna bring you guys back in. And ask you guys what you think about it. So I'll see you in a bit. So I'm here at our old spider spawner thingamabob. And I leveled up to level 30. Is it nighttime? It is nighttime. Great! I leveled up to level 30 because I need to enchant something. And some of you will be shocked. But before we do that, let's take a look at what I did. Not much. But I guess I kind of defined the style I want to go for. As I mentioned, the rusty plates and this chiseled stone brick. Not stone brick, but brick texture, which is kind of a variety of bricks. I kind of like it. It really seems like worn down and stuff. Problem is, that's all the bricks I had. And now my next step would have to be... let's go back to the lab. Would have to be to do clay hunting. And clay hunting is annoying, really annoying, because you have to dive down to the water, sometimes really deep, so you need respiration, you need a really good shovel to get all the stuff. And that is what we're gonna enchant. Look at that. A diamond shovel. When have you ever seen me using a diamond shovel, huh? That's definitely something that I don't do anywhere, I think. Thing is, we need some luck with the enchantment. I need either Silk Touch. Well, no, I don't even need Silk Touch. I think I need Fortune. Oh, that's not how you enchant stuff. Fortune is pretty much the only way, because Silk Touch, I get the full clay blocks. I can't convert them into bricks. And yeah, I need Fortune. To get, wait, 1 second. I'm just thinking about it. Do I always get 4 clay when I mine a clay block? I don't remember. For some reason, I was thinking like glowstone. Like you need fortune to get 4 dust out of 1 glowstone. Otherwise, you'll lose when you mine without silk touch. But I don't know if it's the same for clay or if you always get 4 out of there. We should try that. Oh yes, we got fortune nonetheless, so that's good. That should definitely help us. Because otherwise, if you don't get all of it out, well, if you do get all of the clay out of a block, even without fortune, why would you need fortune on a shovel? Just for flint? That wouldn't make any sense, would it? Anyways, I now got a fortune 3 shovel, which makes me very happy. And I have this old leather respiration 1 helmet, which is not much, but it's better than nothing, right? And I got it from a mob, I think. I don't want to level up to 30 levels again just to enchant a helmet. The thing is, this is very inefficient. It takes such a long time to get up to level 30. So I really gotta look into a possible Blaze XP farm. That's so much work though, and we have so much other more awesome work to do instead of grinding. So oh my god! Wow! What? I need to free those two. I hope they are not dealing damage to me. Hello, my friends. Is your hitbox bigger now too? I'm gonna free you, don't worry. Sorry! I didn't mean it. I didn't think about that. Their hitbox is so much bigger. Wait, how did you get out of there? Oh, yeah, I just opened... No, did I open it up? Yeah, I did open it up. Okay, so that makes sense. Can I... Okay, I don't want to hit you. Oh! Okay, pigs can get out. But hit... Let me check that. What was it? F3 and B? Was it not F3 and B? Could have sworn it was F3 and B. Maybe not. Maybe I'm wrong about that. Okay, let me see... Can you please turn around, Manny? I wanna get this block so you can be free! Man, maybe this enclosure thing wasn't a good idea at all. Maybe this side? Come on. Can I push you around a little bit? Would be nice. Do I have to get pistons? No, even pistons wouldn't work. Man, you are big! Oh my god, he's huge! Okay. Another one, and... That is still only one diagonal block. Can I... How can I get you out of there, my friends? I really want to. Oh. For a brief second, I couldn't mind this guy. Ah! They are trapping themselves in there because they're so big. I saw the hitbox there of the stone block. Maybe this one? Come on, I just want to get you out of there, my friends. Oh. Okay, let's try... Oh, yes. Okay, just this one. If I can get rid of this, we should be good. Can I push you around at all? No. No chance. I don't want to kill him. Can I see the health? Yeah, he already took some damage. Oh, crap. Okay, but he would... Oh. How did I do that? Okay, please, let me just... Would you just turn around? Oh. Yes, that should help. Yeah! Be free! Look at him! Man, he's huge! Manfred! Manny! Wow, look at that! That is insane! I can get you free too if you just let me... Wait, are you going to get back in there? Oh! Okay, that looks good. Let's get rid of this. Wow! There's no way they can disappear on me now. I would see them from miles away, wouldn't I? That is insane! They're so big! Oh my god! That is amazing! Is my fence high enough? I don't know now! They are a lot higher than I thought. I mean, this will be high enough, but... This one? Barely. Wow! I'm impressed. Well, they didn't despawn, so either we had a really weird glitch before, or they fixed it in an update. But neither the named nor the unnamed one vanished this time. Maybe they really suffocated somewhere, you know? Because this time I confined him in this little area where nothing could happen to them. Maybe they ran into the cave back there and suffocated. That's always a possibility. But look at that. Isn't that epic? Man, that... Oh, wow. Look at this. Beautiful. Have fun. I hope the enclosure is big enough for you. Oh, I can pat you on the head. Money. I don't know. Should we call them money or Manny? Money? Manny? Money? Money, money, money. I think I'm going to call it money. That's funny, yeah? Alright, so I hope you enjoy your stay here. Look at those two. Man, this is amazing. I love it. I love it a lot. And I think we should get a third one to fill this up. I think three would be a good number, possibly. I need to check on the other names that you guys suggested, because now I think we can name our second one too. So I'm gonna go through the list again, and I'm gonna see if I find a fitting one that I really liked. But anyways, I think it is time for me to do some clay hunting so we can make some progress on this here. I really want to get at least the warehouses done today. It would be awesome. Seriously? Come on, game. Are you kidding me? What happened? Money! And his friend. There's no way. So, this makes me believe that they are dying somewhere. I couldn't tell you where. I haven't seen them since I went and did some clay hunting. I came back and I see this. Can you believe it? They can't get out of here. There's no chance. What happened? Can they suffocate in leaves or something stupid like that? I haven't even checked their hitbox yet when they're big. But it is certainly wider than two, so I mean, if they are too high, maybe they could suffocate up there? No. That would be stupid. What could have happened? Maybe they walked in here and suffocated? But both of them? In such a small amount of time? That doesn't make any sense to me. Come on, can we not have some nice things in here? I was so happy with those two big guys. They were beautiful in here. Is the snow doing something? No, I can't imagine the snow doing something. Those are half slept. They can't suffocate in these fences. The other option, they could suffocate if they walk in here. But once again, both of them? That is ridiculous. So either we have a lot more than only one place in this enclosure where they can actually suffocate, or they were just really unlucky. But this is stupid. This is ridiculous. I don't know what to do, guys. I have no clue on what to do with this mess. Oh, we're losing mammoths left and right. And I don't know why. I doubt that you guys have any new ideas. I already asked you and you said, yeah, they're despawning if you don't give them name tags. No one actually said that they would die from anything. But one money definitely had a name tag. You saw it. You saw it. And he's gone. He's gone for good. I have no clue what happened. No idea. Oh my god. This is frustrating, you know? This is frustrating. Alright, let's take a look. I got a bunch of clay, which won't get me very fast. Let's see. One stack should give me 16 bricks. So this is one stack of bricks. Two stacks of bricks. Almost three stacks of bricks. I don't know if I can get a full building out of that. I mean, this was like one and a half stacks. So I definitely could get further, but I definitely can't finish it with that amount. So I gotta go back in the water, back in the ocean, and dive some more. I still have my respiration helmet. Yep. Dive some more and gather some more clay. The good thing is there are lots and lots and lots of clay pockets down there. Very nice. I remember back in the days of Minecraft beta, clay was so rare. You had to go so far to find a single batch of clay. I mean, it made it kind of ridiculously hard to get it, but at the same time it made it so much more valuable. And now clay is like everywhere, and you can even get hardened clay just like that from mesas. But anyways, I'm not gonna rant about the good old days. I'm gonna go and gather some clay, and then I'm gonna try and make some progress on the warehouses. And try not to be too sad about the mouths being gone. It looks a little weird, not really like a real warehouse. Basically, I think the reason is because it is square-shaped, kinda? I don't know. I like the style. It kinda reminds me actually a lot of the smeltery rebuild. I didn't intend it to be, but it turned out pretty much the same shape. But I think it's alright. The warehouse kinda have these windows up high always. Or at least they used to have. Nowadays they don't have windows at all, as far as I know. And that's what I tried to incorporate. I got some vertical half slabs with the carpenter's blocks to add some additional detail. I actually wanted to try something up there in this little quadrant. I might try that here in a second. I have also an idea for the roof. I need to see if that works out. I'm only living off these two furnaces, which might be not very efficient, but it has worked so far. I only get like a couple of bricks at a time, then I build again, and then I have to do other stuff until I get some more bricks, and so on. Not the most efficient way, but it worked out. So how do I get up there now? I really should carry some ladders around with me. I think it would be very helpful. But yeah, this is how I did it. Just boop, 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 and boop. And then fill these in. And then hammer them in! Bam! And I think I want to keep the same size. I really like how this alleyway is going to feel here. Like, I'm going to take this stone around and probably to the back and have another little storage pile of stuff here. I think it could be cool. This warehouse is going to be a little better, I hope, because it's going to be longer. But at the same time, it's not as wide as the other one. You know what I probably should have done? I'm not gonna change it now. But what I should have done is, I should have started with the smaller one, which is less wide, and have making it, well, having it the same length. But then it wouldn't be square, it would be rectangular shaped. And then I could have a wider one over here and have that going further into the back. Fabe, why you no think? That could have been so much better. It's alright. I think we can totally live with that, with what we're at. And, let me see. Do I have some wool on me? I don't think I do. Should I grab that on camera? Let me grab that on camera. For the roof, there, I don't want to do a flat roof like most modern warehouses have. I also don't want to do just a pointy roof. I have a special kind of roof in mind that I have seen on some old big halls or warehouses, I guess. I need these guys for that. And let's grab some. Do I have some wool in here? It should be just enough, to be honest. So let's move back. I hope it's gonna work. I have no idea. Well, it will work. The question is, I have no idea if it will look any good or if it will just be totally horrendous. But initially I thought I put something like an ED on there for E-stock, but I don't have enough space even closely. So I think this is also a good thing to put on there. That would make sense. Paintings. Huh? Can you guys guess which ones? Can you? Of course you can, because I've used them in the past. However, I think it's good to have them here too. Don't fall down there, please. Not you. Not you. Good old painting randomization. I haven't used this one yet. I need to use that at some point too. It's also another custom one I made. I don't know if I showed it to you. Are you serious? Come on, Fabe. Get your game together. Nope, not you. Not you. Not you. Can we do it? Not you. But 2x2 is a good start. That's the other one that I'm gonna need. So now you know what's gonna come. Come on. Is it so hard to get this one painting done? Can't be too so hard. Boop. Nope. Wait, where's the other one go? Oop, in here. Oop, oop, oop. Painting randomization, guys, seriously. Seriously. All right, that's it. I'm not gonna let you guys sit through this. So, this is what I had in mind. I mean, I like the picture, but it looks a little weird. But you know these large buildings that have these boop, 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 boop. However, this angle, it seems way too steep. So, you notice probably what I hold in my hand. And this might be the answer to all our questions. Well, not all of them. But maybe this one, at least. Instead of having them like that, of course I use the carpenter slopes as I mentioned. I want to try out how it would look with those guys. We have a problem. We have 11 blocks here. So we either can have two zigzags or three that don't really like, that are different sizes because 4, 3, 4. And with the two, we could just leave like a gap in between and make them both 5. So I think I'm gonna go for that. Let's just get rid of one of them first and replace it with the collapsible carpenter's blocks. And then we will see what will happen. Okay, let's say we wanna go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 high. So what we need to do, we are gonna have a carpenter's block right, I'm not gonna place it yet. Right here, probably here too. Then let's say we have a full block, and do we gonna go one further up? I think we might have to. Oops, that was the wrong then. Let's do it like this. So I have only worked with those guys here once, but let us see. Oh, look at this. He automatically recognizes what I want from him. This is amazing. How does it do it? Oh, no, that's not what I wanted. This time you messed up, my friend. This is not quite what I had in mind. Okay, let me do one. Oh, wrong direction. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Is that straight? No, that's not. Whoa, crap! Well, I guess I'm down here again. Let's go back up real quick. I'm gonna get rid of all this dirt. Don't you worry, I have a good shovel now. It shouldn't be an issue. Let's go one deeper with this. One. Oh. One. And now it should be straight, right? Oh, yes, that's a perfect slope. Now, there's just one missing. Oops! That's not how it works. Can you not do this? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Is that working? As you can see, the textures are still pretty messed up. It's hard to say, isn't it? It is really hard to say if this is like a continuous slope or if it's actually... I don't know, but it looks decent. Let's try it out. Let's raise it. Boop. Oops, not there. Back there. Boop, boop. I think that's better. I think this is what I'm looking for. As you can see, for some reason, this texture is still really distorted. So, this is a big issue, actually. Why? Why does it have to be this way? But I think the slope looks pretty good. I mean, on top doesn't matter. I couldn't care less about the top today because we won't be able to see it from down there. Oh, yes. Shovels are awesome, guys. Why did I never have a shovel? Keep reminding me in the future when I don't have a shovel anymore. I should get one. Yeah, that's a good slope. I like it a lot. But yeah, this is not right. So, one option could be to use these rusted plates instead, or to just ignore it and maybe say, okay, this is worn down quite a bit and the bricks are not in perfect shape anymore. Wait, is that right? Look at that. There's like a mistake, isn't there? It looks a little weird. It doesn't look like a straight line. We need to check this out. Maybe it was just a texture glitch. Okay, let me turn off the shaders here for 1 second, just to confirm again that this is indeed, yep, this is indeed a shader problem. Look how perfect it looks like that. This is still not right. We need to make this one higher here. This one, right? Boop, boop. This is also not right. You know what I think it is? I think you can't divide it by 2. It is probably an uneven number of hammer thingies to get it all the way up or down. And this is why it can't be perfect. Ah, this is a little annoying. Maybe we need to go with another slope instead. But I like this one. I really do. Let's go down again. I think it was less visible. Yeah, you see that? It goes a little bit in and comes out again, and the other way around, it goes a little bit out and comes in again. It's really, really close, but it's not perfect. Ah, that's a bugger. You know what? This world doesn't look too bad without shaders, does it? I think it looks pretty cool. Let's turn back the shaders on for comparison. Ah, shaders do a lot. I really wonder what the deal is with those. Maybe I should Google if there are any fixes. Maybe there are some hot fixes that people came up with. If you guys know anything about it, as always, I would be happy to read your insight on the subject. But this is probably what we have to live with for now. I mean, let's see. I could possibly... It looks like it's only 4 wide right now, although it already starts back there, so maybe I could raise it by 1. Let's go further back and see what it looks from back here. Maybe you will be able to see it. Yeah, now it looks like 5 wide, so we will have to keep it 5 wide. I like the slope. This is a nice slope. I really want to keep it this way. From all the way back here, you can't even tell that the bricks are not aligned correctly. So I might ignore that in the hope that in the future, sometime, this shall be fixed. But I highly doubt it, to be honest. Because I don't think carpenter's blocks are not really getting updated anymore. Shaders are still getting updated, but more for the 1.8 version. And I doubt it's a shader pack problem. It must be a shader mod problem. So we will have to live with it for quite a while, I think. Anyways, I really like it. Let me change the other one too now, and then we're going to look at the result. Alright, I think I've done enough roof work for today, but look at this! Huh? 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 Maybe? Oh crap, I'm still short on a couple. I forgot to place these back in. Oh no, I need to chisel! Quickly chisel! So yeah, I only got one of the warehouses done and only the outside. Far less than I wanted it to be, but I've worked on this for hours. As usual, when I get back to building, it felt really good to get back into building. I'm gonna place some more bricks probably in there too. But yeah, those are supposed to be windows that are opened up. Like they swing open and they can close again. In theory at least, like in real warehouses. And if we go down, we should have a good look at it from the outside and from the inside. So as I mentioned, this slope is pretty good and you can even see the windows facing up a little bit. So I like it. I'm definitely happy with it. I added these little dents to try and give it a little more detail because it looked pretty plain just having the bricks down there. It definitely helps having this vertical half slabs there. So overall, I'm pretty happy with how it turned out. Looks really like old school warehousey, I think. And even if you get in there, you can see like the windows up there. Still have to figure out a little bit of the ceiling design. I might do like cross beams of the rust plates here. And yeah, but interior is a whole different story. I just want to get lots of chests and shelves in here, I think. That's kind of the goal. To store some imaginary dinosaur food for all of our friends. But guys, we're running out of time for today. So we got one warehouse done. I might work on the second one off camera if I get some time. Because it will look pretty much the same, I hope at least. So, nothing too exciting going on there. But for today, I'm gonna call it. So I hope you enjoyed, and if you did, leave it a like. and make sure to come back for the next episode in the Dinosaur Mine. But until then, have a nice day, and seriously guys, don't be daft! Play some Minecraft!